Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Now you can skip forward to the review here today, the tour of Rome that Shu Omi will be doing today with us, but I just want to fill in a few gaps at the start of this video so you can use the timestamps to skip ahead if you do want to. Now if you haven't heard of Rome yet, it is sort of like a note-taking application that combines this concept of network thought. It's being talked about a lot in the space, the likes of Thomas Frank, many popular YouTubers are talking about it now as almost this new revolutionary note-taking application. And although it's not necessarily definitely a note-taking application, it does look very much like a note-taking application and combines some features that a lot of people really like. And there's almost this cult-like nature around the application. Now, in today's video, I'm going to be passing over to Shu, who will be doing a tour of how he uses Rome research. Now, as you can see in the video, he touches on lots of different things, like how he uses it as a resonance calendar for morning journal, and also how he's made his account structure, which is very important for many people starting out on Rome. So I'm going to be passing over to Shu today. I'm going to be touching more on Rome over the next couple of weeks. So if you want to check out the course that's available below, Shu has an amazing YouTube channel, which you should follow as a big thank you for coming here on the channel, in the description below. And also I'll include any other details, some of the articles we're posting about Rome research. So folks, I will be back soon fully. I obviously still trying to sort out the haircut, so I probably won't do many videos with my camera, but hopefully I'll be back soon and I'll talk to you all very, very soon. Pass on over to Shu Omi for our Rome research.
Hey everyone, my name is Shu. I'm a data scientist and YouTuber based in Tokyo. Today I want to talk about my favorite note-taking app called Rome Research. So this is my Rome. It's very simple compared to other apps like Notion and Evernote. All you have is basically this a daily note, and you know, you can pretty much do anything in this page. You write anything in your mind on your daily note. But let me show you how I use my Rome. So every morning I open Rome and use my daily note template, which is this. So let me start from the start, which is morning journal. So morning journal is exactly what it sounds like. Basically, I have five questions I would like to ask myself before starting my day. And those are, you know, what are you grateful for? And what do you want today's highlight to be? Daily affirmations, what's on your mind? So this is for brain dumping, which I find incredibly useful. And every morning I just write down everything in my mind in this section to clear my mind. And finally, I have today's plan. And thought is, you know, just my ideas I get during the day, and workplace, resonance counter, and evening reflection. These are quite, you know, similar questions I had in my morning journal. So I asked myself, what happened today? What could you have done better? Amazing thing that happened. And what did you learn today? And positivity score, which is some silly thing I would like to do. So let me show you an example of this template. So this is a daily note for today. So I've already done morning journal. So I answered the five questions, and today's plan was to write a newsletter and make a new video for my channel and another video for Keep Productive, which is this video I'm currently filming. And then you have a thought. So this is, as I said before, just ideas and thought I had during the day. So whenever I get a good idea, I just write it down on this in this section. So for example, this morning I realized that people are more interested in Remnote, which is another note-taking app that I'm also interested in. So I wrote, perhaps I should make a video about it. I wrote other things as well, such as I should work on my blog redesign, because my blog is currently, it looks really bad, so I want to work on that. And some other things as well, P on my school. This is a project I'm currently working on. P stands for a project. So I wrote down some ideas. And next, workspace is where I, you know, keep record of what kind of thing I did during the day. So at around 8 o'clock, I was working on my email newsletter. Then from 10:30, I met with my friend Gio and recorded my new podcast. And then on the way back to home, I took a walk and listened to a podcast called Adventure Stories. And currently, for 4:30, I am recording this video. So next is a resonance calendar. I think this is a very popular concept if you have been using Notion. It's basically something Ali Abdel, my favorite YouTuber, invented. It's just a place where you keep a record of what kind of information you consumed. So today, I read an article called 10 Reasons You Should Wake Up at 5 a.m. for 30 Days Straight by Benjamin Hardy, who is one of my favorite bloggers. And then I also listened to Adventure Stories about Conor Wayne Sullivan, who is a CEO and founder of Room Research. So if you, for example, go to this page I made, you can see this is my resonance calendar. So just like in Notion, you can see the date I consumed information and author, source, status, weighting, and you can see keywords such as how to wake up early and massively transformative purpose. Yeah, things I learned such as the concept of moral authority, and this is some of my favorite quote I got from this article. And if you scroll down, you can see the whole article, and I did some highlighting as well. So let's go back to my daily notes. So this is basically how I use Roam pretty much all day. I usually stay in this page and write down everything in the thought section or workspace section. If I'm working on something, I just write down, you know, I can just type time and, you know, doing something. And if I get a new idea, you know, I just write down on this page, you know, do this thing or whatever. Then when I'm actually done that, I can just, you know, click here and mark it as done. So that is my daily note template. And if you want to know more about it, I'm planning to make a video in my YouTube channel, so you might want to check it out. So the next, I want to talk about how to take smart notes. So the concept of a smart note is based on a book called How to Take Smart Notes by Sean Gavran's. It's just one of the best books I've ever read. I read it at least 3 times already, and it's just full of great pieces of advice. So my process of taking smart notes starts from the resonance calendar. So let's go to the resonance calendar page. So this is my resonance calendar page. You know, you can see all the information I consumed which resonated with me. So you can see 10 reasons you should wake up at 5 a.m. By Benjamin Hardy. And this is a YouTube video by Maggie Appleton about Roam, and this one is really useful. I think everyone should check it out. And you know, you can see other things as well. How, why we garden. I'm getting into garden recently, and I love this article. Let's see. Okay, so The Daily Stoic is a book I finished reading recently. It's a fantastic book by Ryan Holiday. So whenever I finish reading a book, I put that information in my resonance calendar. So let's look at the page. So here you can see all the highlights I made in the book. And you know, I made lots of highlights because it was such a good book. So whenever I finish reading a book, the next step for me is always take literature notes. So let's open that in the sidebar. So these are just my, you know, something I learned from this book, from these highlights. I take notes in my own words, and sometimes I quote from the actual highlight like this. And when you finish taking literature notes, the next step for me is to make each note into something called evergreen note. So for example, let's have a look at this note I made. So this is example of an evergreen note I made. As you can see, I have a sort of a format. In the reference information, I have source, keywords, and relevant notes, so I can see how this note is connected to what I learned in the past and you know, other notes I have in Rome. So, for example, this idea, don't let external circumstances determine how you feel, is related to other notes like think of your life like poker and reason a choice. And in this notes section, I wrote down things I learned from this book in my own words instead of just copy and pasting, because writing your words is really important. It forces you to truly understand what you're reading. And you know, this note, in my opinion, doesn't have to be long. It can be just a few sentences, and you know, you can always come back and add new information to this note. So that is my process of how to take smart notes. I explained it really briefly, so if you want to know more about it, please visit my YouTube channel and see some of my videos, because in those videos I explain this process in more detail. Okay, so this is how I use Rome. I mainly use for taking smart notes and also, you know, keeping journal and keeping records of my thoughts and you know, things I've done during the day. But Rome can be so much more than that. You know, you can use Rome for spaced repetition and active recording, you know, which is great for studying. And you can use Rome for, you know, managing your tasks and also, you know, setting goals and reviewing goals. And if you want to know more about these things, I made a few videos in my YouTube channel, so you should check it out. And if you want to know more about Rome, you might want to check out an online course by Nat Eliason. He is a fantastic blogger, and he's made a great online course about Rome. And on top of that, you might want to check out a website called Rome Brain. I think you can find its Twitter account if you type Rome Brain in Twitter. And you know, its website is brilliant. You can find all of the Rome related information in there. So that's about it. Rome is really a fantastic tool. I've been using it for several months. It totally changed how I take notes and how I think as well. So it might look a little bit daunting at first. It might look a little bit complicated or too simplistic. But if you get used to it, it becomes such a brilliant tool for thinking. So thank you so much. I hope you found this video a little bit helpful. If you want to know more about me, or if you want to know, well, if you want to reach out to me, you can always check out my YouTube channel or send me a message on Twitter. Stay safe. Bye.